Good evening, everyone. I hope you're not too tired. And I'm going to talk about my experience in secondary high school in Italy. So I'll talk about my experience with somewhat older students than Alexandra, so around 14-15 years old students. This is the outline of my talk. I will present the school and the implemented scenarios. I will present some students' products and their competencies, and finish with some challenges and strengths point of the quiz project. So, as already said, I am a teacher in Città di Castello, and I've been there. I've been there for 4 years. This is the school. It's a technical institute with a lot of field of studies, such as chemistry, informatics, mechanics, graphics, and so on and so forth. So there are a lot of students. The quiz team were involved around 7 teachers from many subjects and students from 8 classes, around 20 students per class, so for a total of 174 students for attending the second year. I have to say that also first year students got Chris credentials, but we decided to focus only on second classes. These are some scenarios we implemented in different classes. You already heard about that during the day, such as Reach 20, involving math and informatics subjects. The aim of this project was to build an algorithm to produce a computer-based game. Then, as previously mentioned, also as we afforded the scenario, we welcome our guest to produce a tourist map with most interesting places in our city, and automap involving science and physics, whose aim was to produce an interactive map related to hearing. We decided not to complete a full scenario in all classes, but to do a quick part in order to let students achieve at least one sub-competence. In my class, I decided to complete a full scenario in order to motivate my students, so giving a starting point and a final task not related only on specific digital competence. So I will present this last case. This was divided in 4 phases. The first one was the creation of groups, and my students arranged themselves to create these groups and share these either to the Chris platform or by email. This was the first attempt. So the first competence was related to digital communication and collaboration. The next phase was to choose some words related to biology and the physics of the hearing. These are some biological related words, and these are related to the physics subjects. And they also had to specify the reason they choose those particular words. And in this case, also digital communication and collaboration as before, and also search and manage digital information as competence. So as you're going to see, this particular scenario focused mainly on the ARA 2 competence. The third phase was to create a survey based on the words they chose. So either by showing an image or just to doing some question through survey. And in this case, they develop competence in ARA 2, so still communication and collaboration, but also with content creations, such as this service, and digital problem solving in order to understand how to create those service. At the end, they had to build an interactive map related to the results of service. In this case, they also developed a digital citizenship competence. So, just to have a brief look on one specific product of my students, this is an interactive map. The blue point, udito, is the Italian for hearing. And if we click on the top panel related to main diseases, we would be directed to this page. And if we click on the bottom image related to sound waves, we would be referred to this other page. So, and so on and so forth. Just to conclude, the main challenges we met was that this was a pilot study, so students, both students and teachers, took some time to understand how to move and to use this new platform. And due to school business, we were not able to start before February and March. So we just concluded our work by the end of the year, this classic year in May. And in some tasks, there were some particular tools proposed to achieve the final results, but sometimes these tools were not so familiar to students, and we had to find other ways to find the final results. The strength point we want to stress is that, first of all, students enjoy this new kind of doing school, because, as said this morning, it was a different way. And of course, the main purpose is that we can certificate the digital competencies of our students, and the possibility of present in each scenario one specific argument, but afforded from the point of view of many subjects. Some recommendation based mainly on our experience in my school. It would be great if we can start at the beginning of the year, so just even in September. And also let teachers do students, so let teachers to work in a specific scenario, and maybe dedicate some fixed time to the project. Maybe once per week or once each 2 weeks. It depends on the load of request by the scenario. As I said before, maybe some more informatic tools may be introduced in each task, so that students can choose one of them, and maybe they are familiar with one of them rather than another one. And I think that complete a full scenario can be maybe more interesting from the point of view of students, which can see the start and the end of a full path. Thank you.
Is it working? Yeah. Thank you very much, Matteo. Do we have questions from the audience for our last presentation? That's a tough one, I know. Okay. You have one? Great.
Can you tell us something more about the proposition, say, propose more informatic tools to complete tasks? Do you have something in mind that could be added?
Well, actually, in related to the scenario I proposed, AutoMap, there was in the last task, the one to produce the hyperlinked map. It was proposed to do this with a particular program, CMAP, and my students were not supposed to know this. So maybe someone yes, some others no. And so we were at the end, almost at the end of the year, so we cannot able to do CMAP for all students, and we tried to use, for instance, PowerPoint, which were more students friendly in our school, for instance. So maybe I was just suggesting that in that case, maybe the author or the one who arranged this task maybe could propose, okay, you can do this using CMAP, you can do this using PowerPoint or other kind of program, so that maybe each student can choose the one, the program he knows better, just this one.
Thank you. We have another question. Where's the microphone? Yeah.
I just wanted to say that I really like this concept of doing school. It's a reference to Butler, I suppose, or it's just... Did you introduce this concept, or did you read it somewhere? Doing school.
Of doing school?
Yeah.
I don't know.
You
invented by myself.
Excellent.
Yes, just to be more direct.
Okay. We have the concept in gender studies, doing gender studies.
Oh, okay.
It's... And yeah, it has a long history, but it's really great to see it in this context. And I just thought maybe it's for the panel, just a comment, or yeah, for the panel. Okay, something more general, but then, okay, thank you for this concept.
Okay.
Appreciate it.